Hi, this is Team Mango Rabra, shooting a video by myself today. That makes me feel pretty insecure. What does feeling insecure feel like? Well, I don't really know, actually. I guess my heart races a little faster, my eyes are open really wide, and I feel, I guess, excited. Anyway, I want to tell you a story that maybe you've heard before. It's about three little pigs. These three little pigs, they grew up and it was time for them to move out and start their lives on their own. And their mom gave them advice. Hey, little piggies, I want you to do the best you can in life. So the three little pigs went out. The first little piggy built his house out of straw because it was, well, the easiest. The second little piggy, he built his house out of sticks. The third little piggy, well, he built his house out of bricks. And then there came the hungry wolf that loved to eat fat little piggies. He blew down the house of straw, no problem, and he ate the little piggy. Second house he came to, he blew, and he had to blow a little harder. But he got to that little piggy, and he ate him. The third little piggy, however, he blew and he blew, and he, no matter how hard he tried, he could not blow that house down. And in a way, I kind of see us, the RawBrahs, as that's what we do. We help you. We give you the materials. We give you the bricks to build your house. There's two ways we can go about building self-confidence in life. And one way is to create a environment for ourselves, or surround yourself with people that will only tell you their positive truths about you, their pleasant truths. And well, when they have their, you know, irrational, unfair, unpleasant judgments of you, they'll just simply conceal them to allow you to exist in a safe, peaceful environment. And on the other hand, there's another way to build up self-confidence. And this way is not as easy, but it's built out of, well, bricks. You know, you surround yourself with people who will give you their truths, no matter what it is, no matter if it's unpleasant, unfair, constructive maybe, or just straight out ridiculous. And they're going to share those with you. And over time, you begin to realize that, well, their truths don't make you feel anyway. It's you who's making you feel a certain way. You are in control of your happiness or your sadness. And you stop giving power away to those who to share their opinions about you. Your happiness or your self-confidence is no longer contextual, but it's, you can go anywhere and you can be able to absorb the best that life has to offer and not let others or your surroundings, your social group influence the way that you are. And you're there to share your own creativity, your own uniqueness, and to shine your special light. Each one of us has an individual, unique thing about us, and sometimes we have a tendency to want to suppress that because it's much different than other people's. There's a complex going on in the world today. There's actually a few, but one is an inferiority complex, meaning that we think that we're not good enough, or that we don't live up to either the standards that we've set for ourselves or other people's standards. Most time it's other people's standards. And also is that's one of them for now. And you know, I would dare say that almost all humans, including myself, have unfair, ridiculous judgments about people. They're irrational a lot of times, but it doesn't mean they don't exist. And what we've really tapped into exploring this last year, is what would a world look like if we, instead of suppressing those judgments, concealing those because they're unfair, because they're not practical, what if we experimented with letting all those things, whatever is coming up in us, come out? And it's been quite amazing. you would, one would think that, well, why would I want to hear someone's unfair, ridiculous judgments about myself? Well, there's a lot of reasons. So you can start building your house out of stone or out of bricks, so no matter what comes your way, you will know how to twist it and perceive it, turn it not into a stumbling block, but into a stepping stone. In a way, I kind of see what we do as helping people build self-confidence. Like, not the fake kind of self-confidence, not the self-confidence that's brought on by someone giving you some affirmations or some words of encouragement, but that real belief of knowing that you're beautiful, knowing that you're awesome, and knowing that whatever is inside of you deserves to be heard and to be shared. Another complex that's going on in today's world, what I see, is paralysis by analysis. We have the resources in today's world to plan out the rest of our lives. You know, we can most definitely plan out the rest of our week, our month, and actually our whole life we can plan out. But what we get, there's so many awesome things that are proposed to us that we just can't pull the trigger on any of them. We can't make things happen. And we get so stuck in this cycle of just thinking about doing things, talking about doing things, and we never actually do them. Well, sometimes it takes not being practical to get things done. Sometimes it takes, not everything has to be perfect in order to make a move. You just got to go with it. You got to mess up to get things moving in the right direction. So I'd ask you, what are some of your ultimate visions for your life? And also ask yourself, well, why aren't you moving in the direction of those? Are you not confident in yourself? Are you getting caught in the cycle of just thinking before doing? Well, how about, you know how people say, well, make sure you think before you speak. Well, what about if we just spoke before we thought? Wouldn't that be a more authentic way to live? What if we actually just, instead of thinking so much, we did more? We just messed up more. We made more mistakes. See, we're trying to allow people what we've tapped into recently. Like, do you know how many times that my brothers and I have stepped into fear, looked at fear straight in the face, and just, or looked at irrational thoughts and just did it anyways? I would say many times. And if we hadn't done those, if we would have thought practically, if we would have been held back by fear, there's no way we would be where we are at today. And we have a good YouTube following. People really enjoy how we live our lives, and I guess there's a reason for that. But more importantly, I feel like, in a way, I'm happier now than I ever will be. And I hope to continue to maintain this level of happiness or understanding, you want to call it. A lot of times we put happiness on the pedestal. But what I'd really like to put on the pedestal is being present. That's how I quantify the value of my time. How much time am I actually present, where I'm really, truly involved with what's happening right in front of me and not thinking about so much about what happened yesterday or what I'm going to be doing tomorrow. Or not even comparing myself to other people. It's just truly enjoying and being attentive to what's happening right in front of me. Anyway, I know this was a bit of a ramble, but these are just some thoughts I've had recently, and I wanted to share them with you. Anyway, guys, if you're interested in getting involved with what we're doing, the retreats that we're hosting this year, we got Maui in May, Steamboat Springs in July, and Traverse City in August. That's the best way to get involved with what we're doing. Also, the ambassador program we have set up is a really good way to get to know us and to develop a real relationship with you. So if this video has touched one of you guys out there, send us an email, rawbrahs@gmail.com, and let's see how we can work with one another. All right, guys, hope the sun is shining wherever you're at. And if it's not, just remember that you are a creator. So maybe it's raining. Go dance in the rain. There's brilliance to be found everywhere.